We sit comfortably.
Okay, wherever you are, on the floor, on the block, folded blanket, or the chair. Okay, and let's lengthen from the base of the spine upwards, from the hips to your armpits, and you can exaggerate. Lift your arms, take your shoulders back, and just relax your shoulder blades. Flat on your upper back. Okay, well done. And your palms facing upwards, that will give you a little bit more extra rotation, so your shoulder blades nicely flat on your upper back. Okay, and then draw your chin slightly in to elongate the back of the neck, and drop your right ear to your right shoulder. As you exhale, exhale. Okay, lovely stretch. Take another deep breath. And then come back. Come back, and again, chin slightly in, keeping back of the neck long. Left ear to your left shoulder. And take a deep breath, soften all the unnecessary tension. Inhale, come back. Okay, neck is long. Exhale, right ear to your right shoulder. Relax. And then come back. And again, chin in, left ear to your left shoulder, softly. And just enjoy the stretch. So where do you feel more stretch? And then come back. Again, chin in. Slightly in, back of the neck long, and we're going to look over the right shoulder. Look over the right shoulder. Take a deep breath. And then come back, and again, chin in. Look over your left shoulder. And then come back, again. Crown of the head reaching upwards, lengthen. Looking over the right, and now looking into the corner of the right eye. Just looking a little bit more back, like trying to look behind you. Lovely stretch. And then come back. Again, elongate your neck. Looking over the left. And looking into the corner of the left eye. Looking behind you, trying to look behind you. Great stretch. And then come back. Okay, relax. Let's just roll the shoulders, relax. And move your head. Little movements just to relax. Okay, great. And then bring your chin into your chest. And as you inhale, lift your head and trying to do double chin. And you can exaggerate here. Trying to do double chin, double chin, double chin. Lifting your head, maybe look up at the ceiling. And then exhale, chin to your chest again. And again, inhale. Lifting your head, do the double chin, back of the head moving back, neck is long, and look up. Exhale, chin to your chest. We do once more. Again, inhale, lifting your head, moving the ears back, back of the head moving back, and look up. Exhale, and then come back. Okay, well done. And relax again. Draw your shoulders soften, keep your neck soft. Okay, well done. Okay, and now we're going to move head from shoulder to shoulder, just in front of the body. So nicely and gently. Okay, let's do it from shoulder to shoulder, nice and easy. And just checking again how you feel. Where do you have maybe uncomfortable feelings? Maybe this is where you need to stretch. Okay, from shoulder to shoulder, softly. Let's do another couple of rounds from shoulder to shoulder. And then come back to the middle again, take your shoulders back, open your hands, palms facing upwards, relax your neck. So, and now watch me for a second. So we're going to try to do this. We're going to try not to move the nose, and you're going to tune your head this way. And then again, not moving your nose, and then another way. So let's do this a few times. Okay, so pin your nose. Okay, and let's do it. Okay, taking your chin to one side. And then come back to the middle, taking your chin to the other side. And then come back, and again, you don't have to hold your nose. You just try and keep your nose in one point. And you're just turning your head around that point. But then, let's do once more to each side. One side, lovely stretch. Then come back, and then do to the other side. And then come back. All done. And draw your shoulders soften, relax. Great, good stretch. Again, hopefully you feel a little bit looser in your neck. Let's continue to move into the shoulders. Interlace your fingers, invert your hands, and let's stretch upwards. Stretch and lengthen away from the hips, wiggle a little, stretch, stretch. That's very good. And then exhale and relax. And again, draw your shoulders. Great. Now interlace your fingers again in front. Stretch forward and you start to round your back. Round. And then inhale, come back up. Invert your hands, stretch upwards. Keep your back long. We're just going to take arms out and interlace your fingers behind. So behind, lift your chest. This is your back bend. Lift your chest. And move back of the head slightly back. Keep your neck long. Well done. And then again, come back to the front. Interlace your fingers, round. Stretch between the shoulder blades. And then inhale, lift. And invert your hands and stretch upwards. Wiggle. Great. And then take your arms behind. Interlace your fingers behind. Lift your chest. Double chin and lift your chin a little. Well done, we do once more, and again, in front, interlace your fingers, stretch around, stretch between the shoulder blades, inhale, lift, invert your hands, lengthen. Well done, take your arms behind you, gentle back bend, lift your sternum, squeeze your arms, lift your arms behind, lift your chin, lovely, and then come back, roll your shoulders. Lovely, and then we're going to fold forward, working your hands forward and pushing the hips back. Nice and easy, don't worry to go far. Keep moving the hips back and your hands forward. Maybe you can fold a little bit deeper, doesn't matter how far. And then walk your hands back. Well done, change the cross of your legs now. We're going to do the same, change the cross if you're sitting cross-legged, and the same, moving your hands forward and the hips moving back. So this is just a little bit different feeling. Push the hips back, stretch forward, and then walk your hands closer to your body. Well done. Now move the block to the side and come on your mat into the child pose. Okay, so child pose, big toes touching, knees wide. Seat back, and again, stretch your hands forward. Stretch, stretch. On your finger pads, you stay on your finger pads. Stretch forward. And then look at your hands and move your hands all the way to the right. All the way to the right. We start to stretch the sides of the body and the muscles around the hips. So move as far as you can, still moving your hips back to the heels as far as you can. Maybe your buttocks can touch your heels, maybe not. It doesn't matter. Just have a good stretch on the left side. Breathe. Brilliant. And then come back to the middle. You're going to walk hands all the way to the left now, as far as you can. And push the hips back. Feel a lovely stretch around your right side, around the hip, the sides of the body. Breathe. Breathing into the right side of the rib cage. Brilliant. Come back to the middle. We do it once more. Again, walking your hands to the right side, all the way to the right, as far as you can. Stay on your finger pads. Push the hips back. Lovely stretch. And then come back. Come back to the middle. Walk your hands all the way to the left, as far as you can. Moving the hips back again, enjoy the stretch. Just check how you feel in your lower back. Exhale and soften. Brilliant. And then again, come back to the middle. Well done. Take a moment here. Relax completely. on your next inhale, come back on your all fours. Come on your all fours, knees beneath your hips, toes under now. Inhale, look up. Exhale, you round. Inhale, your cow stretch, look up, lifting your tailbone. Exhale, the cat stretch. Inhale, look up. We do twice more. Exhale and round. Once more. Inhale, look up. Exhale, round. And then bring your back parallel to the floor. Make more space between your hands and your knees. And then come up to down facing dog. Inhale, lift your hips high. Squeeze your arms, squeeze your shoulders. Spot walk a few times. You start to stretch the back of the legs a little bit more. Lovely stretch. Don't work very hard. This is just the lovely movements, gentle movements. Okay. Again, checking how you feel. How's the back doing? How's the shoulders? Keep your armpits slightly lifted and squeeze your shoulders, squeeze your arms. On your next inhale, come up higher on your tiptoes, look between your hands, bend your knees and walk towards your hands. Into your forward bend. Listen to your back, listen to your hips. Take your feet wider if you need. Okay. Bend your knees more if you need it as well. One hand at the back of the pelvis. Check in which way the pelvis tipping, forward or back. Definitely forward. Bend your knees more if you need. And then hold your elbows. Relax your neck, just nod your head, relax. And move your arms from side to side, gently, like a pendulum to one side, then to the other side. And it's okay to have your knees bent, especially for the first forward bend. Just take it easy. It's alright keeping your knees bent. Just have a good stretch. This is just a warm-up. Okay, lovely movements. Listening to the body. Respecting the resistance. Another deep breath. And then come back to the middle. Take your hands to the hips. Lift your elbows, shoulders. Lift your chin, squeeze the legs and your hips towards the midline and come up. Squeeze in the legs and your hips. And then relax your arms. Okay, well done. Roll your shoulders. Okay, so let's come to the front of your mat. If you're not there, and we do lovely sequence. So we're going to move from posture to posture to stretch the rest of the body. So bring your hands to your heart. Check space between your feet again, hips width apart, or take your feet wider, that's okay. Inhale, lift your sternum. Exhale, relax your arms. Inhale, stretch up. And as you exhale, forward bend, bend your knees if you need. Touch the floor or your shins. Inhale on your finger pads and stretch forward. It's okay to hold your legs if you need. And then exhale and bar. We do it again. Inhale, stretch forward, either holding the floor or your legs. Exhale, bar a little deeper. We do it again. Inhale and stretch, lift your chest. Exhale, bar. Move your hands by the side of your heels and step back with your right. Right foot back, high leg lunge or lower leg lunge. Take a deep breath into your chest. And if you need to place your back knee down on the floor to take it easy, this is fine. Breathing deeply. And then exhale, stepping back into the plank or half plank if you need to bring your knees down. Absolutely fine. Squeeze your arms, squeeze your shoulders, lift your tummy muscles. Deep breath in. And as you exhale, lean forward. Knees, elbows, or just bend your elbows. Lie down, point your toes back. And slowly come up to raised cobra just halfway, as a warm-up, just a halfway. Lengthen the tailbone, come up halfway of your strength. Soften your buttocks, shoulders lower, the double chin looks straight. Inhale. And as you exhale, drag your hands back and stretch forward. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Toes under, down facing dog, or come on your all fours. And then down facing dog, lift your hips high. Press all finger pads into the floor. Four corners of the hands and stretch your thigh bones back, heels down, deep breathing. On your next inhale, come up high on your tiptoes, look between your hands One possibility, right leg up, step forward, or if you need to bring your knees down first and then step forward with your right, this is also good. So helping with your hand is good. Check in front knee, above your front ankle, squeeze the legs, lift your chest, take a deep breath, maybe even straighten your back leg, and then engage your tummy muscles and step forward with strong tummy muscles. Make space between your feet, hips width apart or wider, squeeze the legs, press down with your feet and come up. Inhale, lift. Salute to the sun, exhale, hands to your heart. Check that you are at the front of the mat and then do the left side. Inhale, exhale. Inhale and stretch. Exhale, forward bend. Bend your knees if you need. Touch the floor or your shins. Inhale, stretch forward. Exhale and bow. Hands by the side of your heels. Left foot back. High leg lunge or lower leg lunge. Whatever is suitable for you on this side. Take a deep breath into your chest. Maybe challenge some strength. Can you let go of the floor or just lightly touching the floor with your finger pads? And then stepping back into the plank. Plank with straight legs or half plank with the knees down. Again, listen to your body. Squeeze your arms, squeeze your shoulders, lift your tummy muscles. And we try to lengthen the tailbone to the heels to engage your core muscles a little bit more. Deep breath in. And then lean forward. Knees, elbows, or just bend your elbows, whatever's suitable. Point your toes back. And we're going to press whole legs into the floor. Let's press the front of the feet, your toenails, your knees into the floor. Lengthen the tailbone and then come up again, maybe halfway again. Soften your buttocks. Move your shoulders down away from your ears. Do double chin. Look straight or maybe lift your chin a little. Inhale. And as you exhale, drag your hands back and stretch forward. Stretch, stretch, stretch forward. Shoulders lifted. Toes under, down facing dog. Inhale, lift. Hips lifting high as you can, up towards the ceiling. Press finger pads into the floor. Keep your armpits slightly lifted. Keep your armpits lifted so you don't want to sag your shoulder joints. Squeeze your shoulder blades and stretch your legs back, heels down. On your next inhale, on your tiptoes, look between your hands. Left leg up, and maybe you can step forward. Big step forward with the left leg. Or if you stop somewhere between, help with your hand again. Bring your left foot forward. Check your knee above your ankle. Squeeze the legs. Lengthen the tailbone. Lift your chest. Deep breath. Exhale, tummy muscles engaged. And step forward. Forward bend. Again, take space between your feet. Hips width apart or wider. Take a moment here in your forward bend. Squeeze the legs. Keep that energy. Press down with your feet and come up. Inhale, lift. Salute to the sun. Exhale, hands to your heart. Take a deep breath. And we're going to practice the tree pose. Look somewhere straight ahead. Options for your tree pose. Tree pose is a balance pose. Options here. Heel on the inner leg, or maybe foot beneath your knee, or above your knee. Or maybe, I know some of you like to do this half lotus, maybe this is appropriate. Just make sure that your hip and your knee is fine with this. And then we stretch the arms upwards. If you need the support, come to the wall. Just one finger, lift one finger on the wall. That's enough. Okay, let's do right leg. I'll face you. Okay, right foot. Somewhere where you feel very comfortable, maybe legs on inner thigh, sorry, on inner leg, or beneath your knee, or above your knee. So find somewhere where you feel very comfortable, or maybe even half lotus, like so, if this is okay. Okay, I have to hold something to start. Okay, hold the ball if you need it. And then take your hands to your heart. And when you're ready, then you lift your sternum, and you stretch and lengthen. Look somewhere straight ahead, at one point, which don't move. And again, squeeze the legs, engage your tummy muscles, and stretch upwards. Keep lengthening. Steady legs. If you have foot against your thigh or against your leg, so what you do, you press your foot into your leg, leg into your foot. Keep your tummy muscles engaged, and stretch upwards. breathe. Big expansive inhalation and controlled exhalation. And as you exhale, I want you to draw your tummy muscles a little bit more in. Great. And then bring your hands together. Draw your hands to your heart and relax. Relax your legs, give your legs a little shake. Relax, relax, relax. And we change directions. Now, heel somewhere on the inner leg, beneath your knee, above your knee, or again, half lotus. So whatever is suitable for you. This is my very, very comfortable position. Okay. And again, take your hands to the hips and just remind yourself, stay the legs. You press your foot into your leg, leg into your foot. Engage your tummy muscles, hands to your heart. Again, look somewhere straight ahead. And when you're ready, lift your sternum and stretch upward. Stretch your fingers like a branches on the treetop and breathe. Breath is easy, flowing, enjoyable. Keep lengthening. Steady legs, strong hips, very strong tummy muscles, core muscles. Calm breath. Another deep breath. And then bring your hands together. Draw your hands to your heart and relax. Relax your legs, give them a little shake. Relax, relax. Okay, well done. And then come to the front of your mat. Okay, with the warrior one pose. Strong posture for the legs, for the hips, and also lovely stretch for the shoulders. Okay, so we're going to step back with the right. Right foot back, big step. And we're going to take feet wider. So the hips width apart, we want to see between the feet. And then you bend your front knee forward and your knee above your ankle. If your knee overextended like so, we just take your back foot back and sit a little lower if this is what you need. So knee above your front ankle. Squeeze the legs and your hips facing forward. You take your hands to your hips and you check. Okay, hips facing forward. I'm going to squeeze my legs towards the midline. I'm going to engage my tummy muscles. And maybe, if you feel very steady, balance is okay, maybe lift your heel off the floor and you turn your foot now facing forward. So your second toe, realign with the middle of your ankle and your knee and facing forward. And then stretch your arms. Stretch your arms and just check how's your balance. Take a moment. Lengthen away from the hips. You're going to bring hands together. Take your hands at the back of your head. Thinking about the arm bones moving back into your shoulder joints or your armpits moving back. And you lift your chin and lean back to your hands. So you have a little bit more stretch now through the front of the body. You're lifting your heart center. You have lovely stretch for your shoulders. Super strong legs. Again, check your legs. Squeeze the legs towards the midline. Breathe deeply and lean back. Breathe. Let's take another deep breath. Super strong legs. Lovely openness in the front of the body. And then stretch your arms up. Exhale, let's stretch forward. Stretch the stretch, push the hips back, touch the floor with your hands, and step back to down facing dog. Down facing dog, good stretch. Hips lifting high. Inner thighs moving back, heels down. And then come up higher on your tiptoes. Look between your hands, bend your knees, walk in. Walk towards your hands, into your forward bend. Make space between your feet, hips width apart or wider. It's okay to take your feet wider. Squeeze the legs, hands to the hips. Lift your elbows, shoulders, lift your chin, come up standing. Squeeze the legs, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Lovely, change side. Left foot back now. Take a big step and again check in. Space between your feet, hips width apart. Bend your front knee, knee above your front ankle. Make more space if you need. Okay, feel steady, strong, hips facing forward, squeeze the legs towards the midline, little bit of tailbone, lots of tummy muscles. Maybe if you feel very steady, lift your back heel off the floor. And again, the second toe on your left foot, middle of your ankle and your knee, realigned and facing forward. And then lift your arms. Take a deep breath. Breathe in deeply, lengthen away from the hips. And let's do extra shoulder stretch. Hands together at the back of your head. Lift your chin. Armpits moving back. So thinking about your arm bones moving into your shoulder joints. Okay, moving back. Lift your chin. Lift your chest. Breath is easy, flowing. Well done. Take another deep breath. And then stretch your arms. Stretch. Lengthen forward. Lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Push the hips back. Look down. Touch the floor. Step back to down facing dog. And again, spot walk. Few times and then stretch completely through the whole back of the body. Enjoy. Enjoy the stretch. With a breath deep and flowing. On your next inhale, on your tiptoes, bring your knees down to the floor, sit into the child pose, knees wide to the edges of your mat, big toes touching, and you're going to sit back as far as you can, stretching your arms forward, and maybe you can go on your finger pads, walk your fingers forward, moving the hips back, lengthen, and then soften completely. Forehead is on the floor or on your hands if you need to use hands or if you need to use more space. Fists beneath your forehead. And soften. Deep breathing. Well done. On your next inhale, lift your head and then slide your hands closer to your knees. Brilliant. And then stretch your legs in front and relax your legs. Just stretch your legs, give them a little shake. Okay, well done. And then you're going to sit in Padakonasana and looks like that. It looks like that. Your feet together. So you have four corners of the feet touching. And if you need to sit on the block or folded blanket now, please do sit. So it gives you more comfort and more space for the hips. I'm going to find my block. So this is my brick. This is quite high for me. So I'm going to find a yoga block, which is here. Okay. And the yoga block is a little bit thinner. So it's, for me, this is just the right size to sit on. So please do. Make yourself comfortable. Folded blanket, block, or maybe even the brick if you need it. Okay, squeeze your feet. Okay, and you're going to lengthen. Lengthen in from the base of the spine upwards, and you hold your shins above your ankle joints. And as you exhale, engage your tummy muscles and let's fold forward. If you have space, but don't worry, if you feel there's no space for you to fold forward, that's okay, just to stay here, sitting and keeping the breath. On the inhalation, lengthening, on the exhalation, tummy in and folding. It doesn't matter how far. And if you're folding a lot forward, then move your elbows wide and you press your elbows into your legs and your legs up into your elbows. So you're trying to create resistance here between the arms and the legs and keep stretching forward. Keep stretching, stretching, lengthening. And looking at your feet now, again, check four corners of the feet pressing against each other. Your toes active, so there's lots and lots of energy on your legs. Squeeze the feet, push your thigh bones back, lengthening forward. Lovely gentle stretch for the back of the pelvis, for the hips, for the lower back. Great, now come back, inhale, come back. Relax your legs and shake your legs. Relax, shake, relax, relax. We're going to do once more. Okay, when you're ready. Okay, bring your feet together again. Four corners of the feet, pressing against each other. Toes active. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, squeeze your tummy muscles in and start to fold forward again from the hips. Elbows moving wide. Press your elbows on your inner legs. And your legs up into your elbows and keep stretching forward. Squeeze in your feet. If you look at your big toe, at the joint of your big toe, press against each other. Press, press, press. Lots of energy. Thigh bones moving back. Legs pressing up into your elbows and elbows down into your legs. Good resistance here to engage the muscles, especially on your inner thighs. Nice workout for your inner thighs. Take another deep breath. And then come back. Inhale, come back. Well done. Stretch your legs to the front. Give your legs a little shake. Relax. Okay. And sit and watch me for the next one. So the next one, we're going to do this. It's called a side stretch, and then we go into the forward bend. So in the side stretch, we're going to do this. We're going to fold one leg. If it's okay with your knee, it's okay to have this leg straight. You don't have to bend your leg. Then you're going to check your lower back. Maybe again, you need to sit on the block or folded blanket. And we go to the side stretch first. You're going to look at the bent leg. Inhale, and as you exhale, you're going to go this way. And you're going to try to move your head as close as possible to your heel. This is where you might need again block or the brick, or maybe you just can touch the floor with your finger plants. And you can stop here, shoulders back, and then you're going to stretch one arm upwards. So this is one option. Another variation, if you can walk a little closer to your foot and you can hook your big toe with your thumb, so you have to open your palm facing up and then you hook your big toe, and maybe you can take this arm, toe palm over the head. So this is where you have super stretch. And again, you're going to fold and fold and fold, then come back, then we're going to turn shoulders forward and we go into the forward bend. Then we come back and we change side. Okay, so let's do it together. So bend one leg. So it doesn't matter which one you're practicing. So bend, heel into the groin, sit on the block if you need. Just take one hand at the lower back and check how the back doing. Is your back straight? Are you comfortable? Maybe you need another block here for your hand, block or the brick. Okay, don't worry if you don't have props. Just touch the floor with your hand. Okay, looking at your bent knee. Inhale and lengthen. Let's just lengthen, keep the length. Okay, take one arm behind and walk your hand closer to the foot. Closer and closer and closer. And again, you use your breath. Inhale, you stretch. Exhale, walk your hand closer to your foot. Now, taking the top shoulder back, straighten your back, and then stretch your arm up. Look up. If it's okay with your neck, or just look to the side. And again, use your breath. Inhale, you stretch through the both sides of the body. Exhale, you fold above the straight leg. Okay, if you can hook your big toe with your thumb, you have to open the palm facing upwards, hook your big toe and carry on folding. Inhale, lengthen, exhale, fold. Toe palm moving over the head. Well, this is a direction. Don't worry to go far. If you have to just stretch upwards, absolutely fine. I know this quite intense stretch here. And again, inhale, lengthen. Exhale, folding above the straight leg. The top shoulder still moving back and back and back. We want to have a good stretch. Deep breathing. And then come back. Inhale, come back. Well done. And now turn your shoulders facing to that straight leg, to that foot, and go into the forward bend. What I do, I just bring my knee, this bent leg, a little bit closer. So I'm not very open for the forward bend, not to overstretch. So and I'm looking at that front foot, inhale and lengthen. And as you exhale, folding above the straight leg. And again, inhale, lengthen. Exhale, tummy muscles strong, squeezing and fold. And again, inhale, stretch. Exhale, fold. And if you can easily hold your front foot, maybe with one hand, another hand on the floor, or maybe two hands, it doesn't matter. Listening to your back. And again, inhale, stretching through the both sides of the body. Exhale, softening between the shoulder blades and folding. Relax your neck. And again, inhale, lengthening. Exhale and folding. Breathing deeply. On your next inhale, let's come up. Inhale, come up. Lean back, stretch your both legs. Give your legs a little shake. Relax, relax, relax. Okay, well done. We're going to change side. Okay, I'm going to swing around for you. So bend your other leg. Point your toes and take your heel into the ground. And again, check. Is that okay for your knee to have your leg bent, or even stretch your leg to the side? And that's okay. Okay, make space between the sitting bones. Widen, check one hand, with one hand your lower back. Are you sitting upright or do you need to sit on a support? Okay, look at your bent knee. One hand in front, one hand behind. Let's lengthen. Lengthen upwards and then fold one arm behind, and we're going to walk hand forward into the side stretch. Okay, and again, inhale, lengthening through the both sides. Exhale and fold, walk your hand a little closer to your heel. Okay, shoulder back, that top shoulder back, and then stretch your arm. Open your chest and breathe. Maybe this is just enough. You can stop here. I know it's intense stretch, seated side stretch. Or maybe you can walk your hand closer, hook your big toe with your thumb, top arm moving over the head. Over the head, it doesn't matter how far. Listen to your back, listen to your top shoulder. Inhale, you lengthen. Exhale, stretch. Inhale, lengthening. Exhale and fold. It doesn't matter how far you go. Breathe deeply. Inhale, you lengthen. Exhale, you fold. Let's take another deep breath. And then come up. When you're ready, inhale, come back. Well done. Now joining shoulders towards to your front foot. Okay, the hands behind. Inhale, stretch. And as you exhale, tummy in. And we're going to fold forward. And again, inhale, lengthen. Exhale and fold. Once more before you hold in your foot. And again, inhale. Exhale, fold. And maybe you can hold your foot with one hand, another hand on the floor, or two hands. Use your breath again. Inhale, you stretch. Exhale, tummy engaged, and you fold above your front leg. And again, inhale, lengthen. Exhale, soften between your shoulder blades and fold. Relax in your neck. Neck is soft and long. Chin slightly in to elongate the back of the neck. Let's take another two deep breaths on each side, on this side. And then come up. Let's come up slower. Inhale, lean back, stretch your both legs and shake your legs, relax, relax, relax. And then please lie down on your back. Okay, lying on your back with the knees to your chest, rocking and rolling, rocking from side to side. Nice self-massage for the lower back after strong postures. And then with each hand on top of your knee, let's do rolling. Rolling clockwise direction, then anti-clockwise direction. Let's do this a few times. To loosen up the back of the pelvis after strong postures, strong stretches. Enjoy the movements. Lovely, gentle movements. Should feel nice and easy for the back. For the back of the pelvis. Lovely. Take another deep breath. And then roll over to your right hand side. Come up to the sitting. Sit comfortably and watch me. So for the next one, we will need block or the brick. So whatever you have at home. If you don't have props like that, so please do. Just imagine. Just imagine, I'm going to show you with this brick, because it's a little bit easier to use the brick than the block in the next posture. So we're going to work on improving the core muscles, improving the strength of the core. We're going to lie down And then you're going to squeeze the block or the brick. So I'm using brick here between your knee and your elbow. And notice my leg. So my foot is tense, my hand is tense, and I'm going to squeeze this. I'm going to squeeze, squeeze, squeeze to create good tension. So this is where my oblique, the side core muscles already working. So I know if you touch your core muscles, they start to work on one side. And then you're going to do this. Exhale. Tummy muscles in, you're going to lift one leg and arm, and then keep this tension, keep engagement on your tummy muscles. You're going to stretch. We do 5 rounds on one side, then we're going to do 5 rounds on the other side. Exhale, inhale, then you're going to do diagonal. You have your knee and you have your fist here. And you do all the same. Squeezing the block and moving your leg and opposite arm. Okay, let's do it together. So we do 5 repetitions, okay, on each round. Okay, let's do this. Right leg, you have right knee, and you have your right elbow. Okay, so notice your foot is working, toes active, feet is active, and you want to really squash or crush that block between your elbow and your knee. And take one hand, that's your left hand, take your left hand and check the right side of the muscles, so the right side. And you notice that those muscles start to engage, they're working. Now stretch your left arm and your left leg. As you exhale, squeeze your tummy muscles and lift your leg and arm. Inhale, stretch. And again, exhale, lift, squeeze your tummy muscles in. Inhale, extend. Again, exhale, tummy muscles in, lift. Inhale and stretch, and again, lift, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze your tummy muscles in. Inhale and stretch, again, exhale, lift. Inhale and stretch. Well done, we're going to change side now. So moving the block to the left side, you have your left knee and your left elbow. So really crushing this block. Okay, stretch your right arm and your right leg. As you exhale, tummy in, lift. Inhale and stretch. Keep crushing the block. Exhale, lift, tummy in. Inhale and stretch. And again, exhale, squeeze and lift. Inhale and stretch. Exhale, tummy engaged, lift. Inhale, stretch. Once more. Exhale. Inhale and stretch. Brilliant. Keep your left knee lifted. So you have your left knee and your right fist. So make a fist and crush that block between your left knee and your right fist. Okay. When you're ready, exhale, tummy in, and lift right leg, left arm. Inhale and stretch. Exhale, lift. Inhale and stretch. Exhale, tummy in, and stretch. Exhale, lift. Keep your tummy muscles tense. Let's do once more. Exhale, lift. Inhale, and stretch. Change inside. Your right knee, and your left fist. Cross the block. When you're ready, exhale, tummy in, and lift. Inhale and stretch. Exhale, lift. Keep your belly button in and stretch. Exhale, lift. Inhale and stretch. Twice more. Exhale. Crush the block. Once more. Exhale, lift. Inhale and stretch. Well done. Move the block to the side. Knees to your chest, like again, let's again rock and roll. Nice and easy for the back, for the hips, for the back of the pelvis. Rocking, rolling, so whatever you need. So just relax, relax your breath. You worked very hard. Lovely. And now remove, roll over to your right hand side, come up. to the sitting and watch me for the next one. What I want you to do also, to put your socks on now and your jumpers on now if you need it. And then I'm going to show you the twist, and after the twist, you're going to stay on the floor and relax. So the twist is here. This is a lovely gentle twist. We're going to do this. We're going to open the shoulders, shoulder blades flat, elbows, back of the hands on the floor. Or maybe you need to stretch your arms. That's okay, stretch your arms. You're going to take one foot on top of the knee, holding your knee, and then you're going to take this leg on a journey to the side. And then if you can lift your hips and twist, go for it. We're going to think about lengthening the tailbone. And what I do, I place my hand on top of the hip. As I lengthen the tailbone, I encourage this hip to move gently forward, and then this knee gently, gently towards the floor. And I use just one finger. Just one finger here is enough, so because this is already intense stretch. So gently, gently teasing your knee down towards the floor, then come back, straighten your body, and then change inside. After that, you're going to just straighten the body and lie down, close your eyes, and relax. Here, let's do it together. So put your socks on, jumpers on if you need, or keep your blanket somewhere handy so you can cover yourself for relaxation. Okay, and then lie down when you're ready. And let's just make shoulder blades flat on the floor. And we take right foot on top of the left knee. Now hold your right knee with your left hand. Inhale. And as you exhale, take your knee all the way to the left. Okay, as far as you can. And then see if you can lift your hips. Twist a little deeper, but don't worry if you don't have that space here. So, and take hand on top of the hip. Now let's lengthen the tailbone. And encouraging with your hand, your top hip, your right hip, just to move forward just a little. Checking your left foot is active. And then slide your hand your knee and gently, gently tease your knee down towards the floor. Nice and easy. We just want to have a good stretch, and all the twists are great to release tightness or tiredness on the back. We create more space between vertebrae to release the nervous system. So thinking about this top hip still moving forward, your right hip still moving forward, your left foot is active. And you're teasing your knee gently, gently towards the floor with the power of one finger. So that's how gently you can do this. Gently, gently, just to have a good stretch. Okay, checking shoulder blades again flat. It doesn't matter how far you go. Nice and easy. Well done, take another deep breath. And then come back. Come back to the middle. Let's straighten the body first. Lift the hips and straighten. Okay, and we're going to the other side. Okay, now left foot on top of the right knee. Hold your left knee with your right hand. Exhale and moving your leg to the twist. Now again, if you have space to lift your hips and twist, go for it. And easy. Take your hand to the top hip. Lengthen the tailbone and encourage your top hip to move forward. Right foot is active. Just check your right foot is active. That hip moving forward, teasing your knee down gently, gently towards the floor. It doesn't matter how far you go. Again, the power of one finger. Take your time. With each exhale, becoming a little softer. Exhale and becoming softer in your twist. With the power of one finger, gently teasing your knee down. How's the right foot doing? Keep your right foot active. The top hip still moving forward. Creating space and length. chicken shoulder blades flat. I know that the left shoulder wants to lift. Well done. On your next inhale, let's come up. Come up, straighten your body and relax into your Shavasana. So in Shavasana, you're taking your feet wider than the hips and you press the hips into the floor stronger to restore the lumbar space. There is a space between the lower back and your yoga mat, and then you relax your arms, palms facing upwards, shoulder blades flat on the floor, back of the head nicely balanced on the floor, and if you're not sure, just roll your head from shoulder to shoulder, just soften. Come back to the middle, softly close your eyes. Smile to relax your facial muscles. Leave the beginning of the smile on your face. And relax completely. Let go of the weight of the body into the floor, into your yoga mat. Exhale and let go. With each breath, becoming softer and more relaxed. Acknowledge that you're part of the great universe. Only one little spark maybe, but nevertheless, one part of the big plan of life. Important, necessary, because you're part of the whole creation, within it, not outside of it, and you are not alone. The rest of life is needing you just as much as you are needing it, and this binding together, this needing, sharing, caring, makes you feel secure and protected. Enjoy your breath. Relax. Let go of all the unnecessary tension. Now, as your relaxation comes to the end, bring your awareness back to your surroundings. Deepen your breath, wiggle your toes, your fingers, slide your legs together, arms by the side of your body. Inhale and stretch. Take your arms over your head, stretch the stretch away from the waistline. And then bend your knees to your chest, hug your knees, gently rock from side to side, reawakening the lower back. And then roll over to your right hand side, come up to the sitting, and then sit comfortably for a moment. Maybe sit again on the block with your hands in Anjali Mudra in front of your heart. Inhale, lift and lengthen. Slightly lean back to feel the strong support of your back muscles. Support, steadiness of the universe. Reflect your practice. Reflect your intention of the practice. Notice how you feel. Enjoy extra strength, flexibility, and clarity of mind. We finish class with one gentle om. Exhale first. Inhale. Bow your head to your heart, to the light within you, and open your eyes. Well done, everyone. Thank you very much. Namaste, and have a lovely day.